This was the code which we have written in the previous video. Now we'll try to modify this code further and make some modifications to our machine. Let me run this code again and show to you how it was working. So it was printing the number of candies dispensed. I can actually make it, let's say 0.4 to make my machine a bit faster, but not lightning fast, so that I can see the numbers which are getting printed. So you can see here the speed has increased and it stops at 9. So there's a small problem here. So what if, let's say, I want to have some 100 candies here. So using backslash b might not be a very nice way of doing this, right? You see, again we started suffering from the same problem. So using backslash b is slightly complicated and you'll have to play around with it in order to get it in the right way. Instead, what we can do is we can use a simpler solution. We can use another escape sequence, which is carriage return. What carriage return does is it brings you to the first character in your current line and it starts overwriting everything from there. So what I'm going to do now is I am removing this backslash b, and instead the ending character, instead of leaving it empty, I'm writing a carriage return here, and in that case I won't need this flush. Now what is going to happen here? As soon as my first number is printed, which is 1, next time when my second number has to be printed, the cursor goes to the beginning of this current line and overwrites that 1. Let's execute it and see. So as you can see here, my number of candies dispensed is changing. Maybe I can make it all the more faster so that we can see. Okay. You have to wait for some time. Till now it's going all fine. So what happened at the end? At the end I had some problem. So what happened at the end is when it printed a 99 for me, after 99 it again did a carriage return and came to the starting of the line, overwriting everything. So what we can simply do is, what I want is, this end equals to r, it should not be executed for the last number. So when I is 99, this should not be executed. So there are two ways to do it. The first way, which is a more complicated one, is to use an if-else statement. So I can write here, if I is less than 99, then you print I and equals to carriage return. Let me actually do that. I can do, if I is less than 99, then you do this. Else, you only print I. Then let's execute it again. Let me make it speed all the more faster. Yes, so I can see here the number of candies dispensed is 99. There is one more smarter way to do this, even without using this if else. I'm going back and I'm going to print this only. So the problem is, when it was written the last time, then also it made a carriage return. That is the problem. So the last 99, which was written by this print statement, was erased. I want that 99 back. So what I can do, when I come out of this loop, this I is still there and the value of this I is 99 when I come out of this loop. I can actually use this value here and simply do a print I here. And let's run it again. Yes, so it dispenses me 99 candies. Now, this is a simple code. So I runs from 1 to 100 and every time we are printing I, that's it. And we have made some small adjustments to it to make this code more realistic. What we want to do next is assume that What if the machine dispenses five candies at once, not just one candy at once? So I want my sequence to be number of candies dispensed. So first time you get five candies. Next time you get five more, so it becomes 10. So the sequence goes like 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. What you can do for that is I can make a small change in my range here. So this number here tells me from where the range should start. As you can see, it says start thread. This is the number where it should end. Actually, this number minus 1 is the place where it should end. And then I can have a third argument here which tells me the step size. So if I have not mentioned the step size here, that is by default 1. I'm going to mention the step size here and let me make it 2 and see what happens. Let me make it a bit slow so that we can observe what is happening and then let's run it. It's starting from 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, printing only odd numbers. Now it is dispatching candies in like 2 candies at once. But still there is a problem with this code. What is the problem? If I say that it's dispensing 2 candies at once, the sequence is still starting from 1. So if it is always dispensing 2 candies at once, the sequence should also start from 2. So instead of starting it from 1, we'll start it from 2. So now look at this sequence. It gives you 2 candies, then it becomes 4, 6, 10, 12, so on and so forth. It will keep you giving candies. Again, there is a small problem with this. If we look at it in more realistic terms, so your sequence started from 2. So the machine gives you 2 candies, gives you 2 more, it becomes 4, gives you 2 more, it becomes 6, and it ends at 98. So what I wanted is, assume that I wanted 100 candies from my machine, right? Or let's say in this case, I wanted 99 candies from my machine. That's why we wrote our code for I in range 1 to 100, because it will go from 1 to 9. So I wanted 99 candies. It gave me 2, 4, 6. It came at 98 and then it stopped. So somehow the machine is here in this case incapable of giving me that one candy. The sequence has stopped at 98 because the next number is 98 plus 200 and I have to run this code only till 99 because I have written 100 here. So you might need to include some additional logic in your code to take care of that. What if I wanted 5 candies at once? So I start my sequence from 5 and assume that I wanted, let's say, how many candies? Let's say I wanted 40 candies. So I'm going to set it equal to 41 and I still want 5 candies at once. So please remember, this is the starting point, the value from where it starts. This is still where it will go and it will go to that place minus 1. And this is the step size and let's run it. So it gives me 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 35 and 40 candies and then it stops. Now the problem is, what if I wanted 42 candies? The machine is giving me in step size of like 5 candies each time. So if I wanted 45 candies, I'm actually going to write a 43 here and then I run it. It's again going to stop at just 40. So we can do something, maybe we can calculate the difference and print to the user that these are the only candies which can be dispensed. The machine can give you only 5 candies at once. Otherwise, maybe you want to include a last batch. So since I have got 40 candies out of 43, 3 candies are still remaining. So I can sort of show and I can give those 3 candies here. So what I can do is print I. I is going to be what? I is going to be 42, right? So I wanted 42 candies and what else? I think that. And let's run it now. So 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 35, 40 and 42. And then it stops. So you might need an additional logic here. Now, let's do one more thing here. So this one application or one use of for loop was of this loop construct or this repetition construct in programming was we are saved from writing a lot of extra lines, right? Second is, which we discussed previously, was what if this number of candies is an input? So machine asks you how many candies do you want, and then it sort of gives you in certain batch size, which was 5 in this case. So let's do that. Let me take an input, which is, let's say, num, which represents the number of candies. Machine takes the input and it asks you how many candies do you want. And you are writing, I want num number of candies. You give it the input. So how will it go now? I want num candies. So what this should be? This should be num plus 1. And then how should I change this? In order to achieve this, we don't need to do a very big change. So what we have to do is simply, I wanted num number of candies. Some candies are given to me by this loop. The remaining number of candies I'm given in the last batch. So I can simply replace this 42 with num. So in case, let's say the number of candies was 20, right? Then it gives me 20 candies and it again prints 20. And in case I wanted 22 candies, so till here it prints 20 and then I get a 22. Let's do that. Let's run this. So it asks me how many candies do you want? Let's say I want some 17 candies. It's going to give me in a batch size of 5. So I made some mistake here. The mistake is I forgot to convert my input in an int. So by default, my num was string. Convert it into an int and then run it again. Now, how many candies do you want? I want 19 candies and it gives me 19. Right? Perfect. Now, assume that instead of printing candies are dispensed, the machine wants to print how many candies are remaining. That is, let's say you ask the machine, I want 100 candies. The screen shows you 100. As soon as the machine gives you 5 candies, the count becomes 95, that there are 95 more to go. Then it again gives you 5, then there are 90 more to go, so on and so forth. So how do we make that change? Making that change is very easy. So how we can make that changes? For that, let me move to this window here. So let's say I have for I in range 1, 100. If I do something like this, what it's going to do? It's going to print I all the way from 1 to 100. So for I in range 1 to 100, I print I and you see it prints me all the way up to 99. Now I want it in a reverse order. So let's say my batch size was 2, so let me print it. So you will see all the odd numbers here. If I want, so now it is returning me a sequence which is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Now maybe I wanted the sequence in the reverse order. There is a very easy way to do that. So you pass this entire thing to a function which is called reversed and then you run it again. Now you see what is happening. Now it starts from. So there was some execution problem. So now you can see that it starts from 99, comes to 97, 95, 93, so on and so forth. It goes to 1. So it simply reverses your entire sequence. I can use the same logic here. Now instead of number of candies dispensed, I'm going to write number of candies remaining to be dispensed. And I'm going to pass this entire thing in reversed. And let's execute it now. So it asks me how many candies do you want. Before that, in that case, I'm going to print a 0 here because at the end it has given me all the candies. Nothing is remaining to be dispensed. Let's run it again. So how many candies do you want? Let's say I want 19 candies. And you see, I ran into some problem. Let's see what's the problem here. So let me make this time actually 5 seconds so that we can realize what is happening. Let's execute it again. I say I want 19 candy. So first it says me, okay, 15. After 15, it says me 10. Well and fine. After 10, it should tell me 5. But why I'm getting this 50 here? So the problem is with this carriage return. So what this carriage return is doing, when you have 15, what will happen after 15? It will go back to your first location and start writing from there. So after 15, it becomes 10. Even there is no problem. So after 15, it becomes 10. After 10, it has to become a 5. So it goes back and writes a 5. So this 1 is overwritten by 5, but this 0 remains here. So that's why it remains 50 here. So how do we resolve that problem? We can resolve this problem again with the help of a simple function. So what I'm going to do is, as again, the code will become very complicated if I want to print it like 15, 10, 5. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to print 5 as 0, 5. So assume that my machine on total is having a stroke capacity of 1000, right? It can have 1000 candies at max. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to append certain zeros at the beginning of this I using a function which is zfill. And I want every string which I have to have a length of 4 here. If I do that, see what will happen in this case. So I want some 19 candies. So it goes like 0015. Now that problem will be resolved. Right? 0010. And then it will become 0005, so on and so forth. And at the end, it will become 0000. So makes sense. Here, I also might want to do this. So I want 19 candies. So one more thing is this code is starting from 0015. I want it to start from 0019 because that is the number of candies which I want. So at the beginning, I can actually print that number for a while here. We can make all these small changes to your code. So I'm going to make it num and let's it run it again. So I want 19 candies. And it says number of candies remaining to be dispensed. And again, I will also need a time.sleep function here so that we can actually view this statement for a while. So 19, So currently there are 19 candies remaining to be dispensed, then 15, so on and so forth. So what this code is currently doing, if I have 19 candies to be dispensed, so to make it a multiple of 5, in the very first shot it gives me 4 candies and after that it gives me 5 candies each time. So we can even play around with that code and make this sequence something like 19 and then 14 and then so on and so forth. Right? So that can also be done. In that case, I'll actually not use the reversed function. What you can do is I can start from num plus 1. Let's see if that works. So I'm going to actually start from num plus 1. I'm going to go all the way to 0 in a step size of minus 5. We can also use this approach of doing this. So here again, instead of starting from num plus 1, I am going to start from num, and then you should see what is happening here. In that case, I don't want this print statement here. I'll take it back and then run it again. I want 19 candy. So it started from 19. Then first time it did a minus 5, it became 14. Then again, it did a minus 5, became 9. 9 minus 5, it should probably become 4 in the next iteration. And in the last iteration, it gives me 4 candies and it becomes 0. So that is another way in which you can implement for loop. So there are so many things we can do with for loop. Make sure you explore them based on the kind of application you are working on. And in the next video, I'm going to introduce you to newer kind of a loop, which is another loop called the while loop, and we'll see why do we even need that. So is for loop sufficient for all kind of tasks? So we'll see that in the next video.